februaridag i Oslo. Vad gör man där?
Alla vet ju hur en Helly Hansen jacka ser ut, men få vet hur det ser ut i Helly Hansens högkvarter här i Oslo. Och det vill ju alla veta hur det ser ut, eller hur?
Ja, och dessutom är den här snubben på plats idag.
Och det är dit vi ska nu.
Helly Hansen har bjudit in till ett speciellt tillfälle för mig att dels lära mig mer om hur sjökläder funkar, att se och prova deras senaste kollektion seglingsplagg och dels få en pratstund med Thomas Coville. Vi börjar med en titt på kläderna. I förra upplagan av Volvo Ocean Race sponsrade Helly Hansen Mapfre och fick då hemskt mycket input från besättningen om hur kläderna funkade i praktiken ute på världens sju hav. Nu har det gått en liten tid och företaget har dragit lärdomar som implementeras i 2019 års Helly Hansen-plagg. Det är mycket och många små praktiska detaljer, exempelvis fickor på rätt ställe, kragar som inte ska skava eller klia,
men det gäller även
vattentäthet, andningsbarhet och impregnering. Dragkedjor ska också vara praktiska och inte kräva två man för att stänga dem. Bara för att nämna några exempel. På den här jackan finns en ventilationsöppning i bröstfickan. En ny och smart detalj som Mapfre-besättningen ville ha. I varmt väder öppnas den och stängs när det blir kallare eller när det är mycket skvätt. Och så en nyhet för oss som inte nödvändigtvis seglar i södra oceanen.
Och så har vi den här jackan som är ny för i år. Som har, den nya är alltså att den har isolering här och så har den också en vattentät och har stretchtyg här bak, vilket man inte brukar få på sådana här modeller. Samtidigt är det en fleecekrage där.
Men nu ska vi lära oss mer om en riktig äventyrsseglare. Först en liten introduktion. Thomas har jobbat mycket med Helly Hansen och hjälpt till med att förbättra deras sjökläder i rätt många år. Han kommer från Frankrike.
Je ne comprends pas français bien.
I'm not speaking Swedish neither, so okay. I'm sorry.
So we have to do with English.
Yeah. Okay.
And Norwegian? Do you speak Norwegian?
Not yet. No, not at all. Actually, I should. I've been with Helly Hansen for now 12 years.
Yeah.
And I don't speak any words of Norwegian, which is not fair. I apologize.
Can you tell us more about what has been the basis for the development of the new sail garments?
Since 12 years, I think we made a big improvement with Helly Hansen. And I've been very happy to have people who just listen to me. And they were ready to test. They were ready to improve. And we had, like for 12 years, a real conversation. And this is the most important point, I will say, when you have some people like this to, because it's my second skin. It's also my safety. It's also linked to the performance. So it's a lot of compromise.
How would you define a good sailing garment when you're out there sailing around the world in less than 50 days?
The combination between membrane and the way that you can have something very waterproof and use tricks like zip to make it breathable. So you've got something which is durable and breathable because you use it differently and use it with something which I will call more clever. And definitely, this is something which inspires me a lot. And
but you also need to sleep and go to the toilet.
Yeah, and it all those tricks, and it's my weather gears. It's touching my skin all the time, so it needs to protect me, but it also it needs to respect me, and it needs to see where it's touching and where it's scratching. And when it's a lot of little details which is making my life easier, making my life better, making actually at the end my life and my way of sailing more efficient.
That's a good definition.
Yeah.
What person does it take to make a world record attempt like you do first in less than 50 days, and now your new product is trying to reach around the world in less than 40 days?
Yeah.
What kind of person do you have to be? What kind of person are you? Are you a normal office guy?
Definitely. I think I'm a totally normal person. The only thing you need is to be sure that there is no dream that you can't achieve. There is only something. I'm looking like everybody to do something which is really me. I am fascinating by the beauty of a human being, that you are unique, I am unique. I try to find something which is really linked to who I am in action. And when I am offshore sailing, and when I push myself to go around the world by myself in less than 50 days, I think I found really who I am. But I didn't succeed for the first time. I failed a lot. And it's all that story which is interesting. It's not only the victory. It's not only the numbers. It's not only the records. It's all the way it takes me to achieve that. And I think it's because it's very authentic. And it's because it's a real life. And it's because it could have been your life on another project. We all like this, actually. We all like, we fail, we fall down. But we come up and we do it again. We never give up.
What is it that drives you to do these very dangerous trips?
I'm not sure I'm thinking always about the fact that it is dangerous.
Are you scared?
Yeah, I'm scared. I will be a liar if I will say that I'm not scared. And I will be in danger. Being when you go on such machine, you know, Sodebo, my trimaran is 32 meters long, 23 meters wide, 35 meters high. So it's huge numbers. And you need to be scared to be alive. You need to be scared to be safe. If you're not safe, if you forget about it, I think you're crazy or you're in danger. I am fascinating by multihulls. I am fascinating by the new multihulls which are flying today. But it's always the same. It's that kind of a same sensation when I fall in love when I was a kid with the water and with the wind. And I realized that the mother nature was giving me the good balance. At that link with the mother nature is a feeling that never quit me.
Can you tell us something about your new project that you're launching on Saturday?
New project is for me more than a new project, like a new boat. It's actually when I arrived the last time at the end of this around a road trip by myself, I realized how complicated the boat were. And we need to open the door and make something much more collaborating, much more as a team building. So we decided to build a design team with people coming from America's Cup, from people coming from cars, from plane, from Austria, Switzerland, France, America, and with that new way of thinking, we made something totally different. The new boat's going to be more close to 50 knots and 30 knots.
Wow. I have a boat. I have a 30-foot Albin Ballard. It makes 6 or 7 knots. What would you do if you came with me on a tour in the Swedish archipelago? What would be the... would you jump overboard and start a swim?
No, not at all. Actually, I've been sailing on so many boats around the planet. I'm still sailing on moss. I'm sailing on dinghies. I'm sailing on big boats. I'm sailing on monohulls sometimes. But each time I'm sailing, I'm learning. I'm still very curious. I could have that same feeling that I had when I started sailing when I was a kid. I will keep going.
Thank you.
Thank you very
much. Welcome to Gothenburg.
Anytime.
Whenever you like.
Ja, det var trippen till Oslo där. Vi fick mycket insikt i Helly Hansens kläder och en intressant intervju med Thomas Coville. Och det blir intressant att se om vi någonsin får med honom i en Albin-ballad i den svenska skärgården. Det är nog mycket tveksamt.